Hello, people of the internet. Today's video, we are talking about just impressions of Dungeons & Dragons Dark Alliance, not Baldur's Gate Dungeons & Dragons Dark Alliance, the other old games. Alright, yeah, first things first, this is not a sequel to Baldur's Gate Dark Alliance. It's Dungeons & Dragons Dark Alliance. There's a difference. Dungeons & Dragons Dark Alliance, I would give akin to a game or franchise like Streets of Rage, Golden Axe, or another one in that genre. What I mean by that is brawlers. Limited movesets, repeating enemies, but ooh, they look like they are different because they have different colors or different sizes, because that counts. And you're doing the same things over and over and over and over, over, over. Yes, I just made a square box. I don't know why I did that. So basically the game is you play as these four different ranges of classes and you go through these levels and there's 21 of them, so there's quite a bit. You fight some more and you fight some more and you get some loot and then you get a better rating, and if you do you get more points and then you can upgrade your equipment, upgrade your gear. Combat here is pretty fast and can be pretty entertaining, especially when you play co-op, because playing alone is definitely harder. Definitely. I got my butt whooped. But playing co-op is always a blast with most games that are serviceable. I mean, we all did play Anthem. And did I just say that? Oops. But anyway, it is a fun game with friends. It can be fun alone. But again, in this kind of genre, you're going to be just fighting things over and over. And, you know, I will say, I think Dark Alliance actually is a little too long for its own good. I felt like I was starting to get a little burned out by the last, you know, 5 or 6 stages out of the 21, because at that point, really, I felt like I wasn't seeing any new enemies. It was taking longer to unlock new skills with experience because I was having to play on an easier level, getting less experience, but if I bumped it up to a higher level, then I would not get as much experience, or I'd get more experience, but then I would get hurt, and then I would die, and then I'd start over, I could be level, and then I could lower experience again! So by the end there, I was getting a little burned out from it. There are some weird little bugs and glitches, but again, nothing super terrible. I've seen a couple weird animations. My game hasn't locked out. I have gotten kicked out of an online game that I played, and I only played about 3 rounds of an online game. I don't have any friends that play this, because I was gonna, but the PS4 and PS5 crossplay doesn't work because of Sony, apparently. So, you know, yeah, that stinks. I said this on Twitter, if you follow me on Twitter, and I'm gonna say it now in case you're only following me on YouTube. Dungeons & Dragons Dark Alliance is a lot like a loaf of bread. Plain bread. It's good, it's nourishing, and it can even be super satisfying. It might not wow you, and it's not moldy by any means, so you're not gonna get sick from it. But it's also not, you know, like a croissant or anything of that nature. It's just bread. It's just bread. So I give it a bread out of bread. It was fun to me, and I finished it once already, and I'll play it on and off and then go eat some, I'm gonna go eat some bread. Is it the worst game I've ever played? No, definitely not the worst game I've ever played. Not at all. Not at all, so you gotta take that for what you will. And oh my God, there's a huge roach up there! I gotta go get it!